Hi, today we are going to see about quick sorting in data structure. This quick sorting algorithm is based on divide and conquer method. Here we are going to divide a list into two parts. One is the part which is having the lesser element, and one is the part which is having the greater element. In this partition, before first step, we have to choose the pivot element. This pivot element can be chosen on four types. Like you can choose the pivot element in four method. You can choose at the starting, or you can choose at the ending, or you can choose a random element from the list, or you can choose any median element from the list. Similarly, there are four types are there. You can choose according to your wish. So once you have chosen the list, then you, according to the pivot element, you have to divide that list into two part, such a way that all the elements of the left of the pivot should be smaller and the right of the pivot should be greater than that element. So this is the way. As I told earlier, selecting of the pivot is done with four types. One is you can pick the element as a starting element or first element, or you can choose the final element or last element, or you can choose any random element from as a pivot element, or you can choose the median element as a pivot element. In this example, median element has been chosen as the pivot element. According to this quick sort, the numbers or the elements which is lesser than 4 has to be placed in the left side of the list, and which is greater than 4 to be placed on the right side of the list. Here I have taken 5, 4 as a median. Now each and every element will be compared with pivot element. Here 4 is the pivot element, 5 will be compared with the 4. It is greater, though it will be placed on right side of the pivot element. Then 3 will be compared, then it is lesser, so it will be placed on the left side. Then 8 is greater than 4, then it will be placed on right side. Similarly, 6 will be compared with 4, then it will be placed on right side. Again 3 will be compared, it is lesser, so it will be placed on left side. 2 will be compared and it will be placed on left side. So you have got a list like this. Now if you look at the left side sublist, it is not yet arranged in proper order, ascending order. Similarly, the right list also. So these steps will be repeated recursively till this process is getting end. This will be repeated. So again the median will be chosen, then again the same process will be happening. Here again, here also median will be chosen, same like that it will be happening. Similarly, this process will be going on. Now we will see one more example. Here it is given that unsorted list. Now I am going to choose 4 as a pivot, which is the final element of this list. We are going to compare each and every element in the list with pivot element. So the elements whichever is lesser than 4 will be placed on the left side, whichever is greater than 4 will be placed on the right side. To find out the elements lesser than 4 and greater than 4, we are going to take two counters. One is I and another one is J. Now we are going to take the J element for the first element till the element lesser than the index of 4. So first 7 will be compared with 4. So this J will be run up to 5. So 7 will be greater than 4, then J will be incremented. So 2 will be compared with 4, then it is lesser than 4, so this I will be incremented to 7, sorry, I will be incremented to 1, then it will be swapped. So 2 will be placed on the left side and 7 will be placed on the right side. We have to keep remember that left side always the smaller element, right side always the bigger element. Now J will be incremented to 1, then 1 will be compared with 4, again 1 is lesser than 4. So this 1 will be swapped, but this I will be incremented 1, then this 1 and 7 will be swapped because 2 has been already swapped, which is lesser than 4. Now this J will be incremented to 1, so 8 will be compared with the 4, 8 is larger than 4, so same place it will be maintained. Then again 6 will be compared with the 4, so its condition is true, so it will be at the same place. Again J will be incremented more. Then 3 will be compared with the 4, which is lesser than 4, then you have to increment the I, condition is false, so I will be incremented. Then it will move to 7, and 7 and 3 will be swapped. Next J will be incremented to 1 more. Then 5 is already greater than 4, so there is no swapping. Now J reaches the end, which is the before element of the last element. Now this element has been swapped, like left side will be in lesser than 4 and right side will be in lesser than 6. Now this 4 should be placed on the place where this I is placed, but incremented one number in I. So I plus 1 will be the position where 4 to be placed, because the 2, 1, 3 will be the smaller elements than 4. Where I is placed is the last smaller element in the left sublist, so it has to be incremented 1. So I plus 1, in that place this 4 will be placed. So now we have sorted left side of the array is smaller elements and right side of the array is having larger element. So 4 is placed in the in between the smaller elements and the larger elements. Now again this step has to be repeated. So next again you have to repeat the same process for the elements from the index 0, 1 and 2, because 4 is already arranged. Now we have to do the same process from 0th index, 1st index and 2nd index. Now you have to choose the pivot element as 3. Now 3 will be compared with 2, so 2 is lesser than 3, so no need to change. Then again 1 is compared with 3, again it is lesser than 3, so no need to do change, so no need of swap anything. So this will again, this arrangement is over, so no need to do one more change. Next again 1 will be taken as the pivot element. Next 1 will be compared with 2, so 2 is greater than 1, so it will be automatically swapped. Similarly the right side sublist also, again this process will be happening till the arrangement of this element will be happening in ascending order. So that process will be repeated recursively till it is getting arranged. So this is called quick sort. So you hope you understand the concept of the quick sort. So we will meet you in next video. Thank you.